Hey there guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. Do people still use tablets in 2020? Why and why not? Why have tablet declined? There's a graph on screen right now. Higher is better. Well, there's actually a few reasons why laptops have been declining. One of them is folding phones. Yes, now I don't want to get criticism for this. I know it's a new thing, but in half the time, there's no like actual operating system support for it. So like some versions of Android will act funny on it. YouTube stories won't work. All kinds of things won't work properly with it. But the idea of having a tablet that turns into a phone, like by folding it, is better. Because nobody likes carrying tablets around. Like they're just bulky, they're annoying. That's my experience with it, except like if it's really small. I'm actually gonna be doing a review on this old tablet. This is the only tablet I really have. I don't really use tablets, so this is the Galaxy Tab 3, Android 4, dude. It actually still works pretty well. I just use it as YouTube music on the speaker, so. yeah, also, one more thing. Two-in-one laptops. Now, you have saw this with the 2020 iPad, which does have a keyboard and everything else. It doesn't really feel like an actual laptop, not like the ones that are magnetic. You just actually sit in the thing and it would actually be like a laptop. That doesn't really feel like a laptop. It feels cheap. The first ever detachable laptop was in 1993. Yes, you heard that right. 1993. Of course, it was heavily criticized as there were no uses for it. It was called the Concerto. I really don't know how to say it.
Compact concerto. Concierto compact.
Pictures on screen, of course. But when the compact came out, at first people thought it would just die because, I mean, well, there was no support. People were trying to figure out a way to use it. And this is when, like, Windows was early, too. So there wasn't support for pens. Wacom tablets weren't really a thing. There weren't really any uses for them. But 2 decades later, which means pretty much at CES 2011, Packard Bell, Acer, and HP all had Microsoft Windows-based 2-in-1 PCs, but Lenovo released the best 2-in-1 laptop ever released. And it was pretty cool. Like, it worked really well. Everybody was shocked by it. It got on, like, New York Times, everywhere, okay? I don't know any other streaming services. God, it was pretty cool to see. I mean, no one knew they could draw pictures on a freaking screen. So for a lot of people, especially artists, this was good news. Because back then, guys, if you wanted to make something digital, you had to scan it and do all this process with a painting. Yeah, it's complicated. Like, it's hard to get a copy of a painting digitally without taking a picture of it. Because then it loses its value, right? So it was pretty complicated at the time, but now they could just draw it on there. Also, tablets are just boring, okay? Like, there really isn't any uses for it when your phone can just do everything your tablet can do. Well, except watching the new Avatar trailer, because it's apparent that those are never gonna come out. Their cameras suck pee-pee. Like, even the iPad cameras now suck. It's like iPhone 4, alright? Get out of here. Like, even in 2020, it's awful. But if you guys actually do want me to review this tablet, like and subscribe, because I totally will, and it's not too bad, actually. Even if it's a device you don't use, put sticky tape on it or something. So what I do, I just put sticky tape, blacken it out, so like if I can do this, guess what, the camera is not scratched. Even if it's a device you don't use, you should always respect it, you know? Subscribe, like, comment, dislike if you didn't like it, and I will see you in the next video.